in the years since the piano was invented.
Once you start playing, you forget, or at least I forget about everything else.
USC student Claudio Oliveira says the passion for the sound has stayed the same, but in some ways, John Adair, owner of Adair Piano, says it has completely changed.
You can hook up to the internet, you can download music.
He says now pianos are wired beyond their strings.
You miss a note, you can put that on the computer and correct that note.
And students like Claudio use Adair's Yamaha Disclavier Piano in Colombia.
I actually use this technology to teach 3 students in Canada that I've never met.
To take a long distance lesson with teachers like Dr. Stella Sick in Minneapolis.
I think as an organic addition to the ways we learn things and to the ways we communicate with one another.
Claudio presses the keys here. They're pressed on the piano in Minnesota. And vice versa. Dr. Sick says travel time and distractions are eliminated.
And I'm also focusing on how the sound is produced because I can see the keys and I can see the pedals.
Lessons, performances, and ideas tickle the ivories. Well, the wood these days, across the internet superhighway.
And you're hearing your piano being played by them.
They say there's nothing quite like hearing the piano played live. Now the sound created 300 years ago can be heard from any distance.
This is a performing art. And so being able to do it on another level where the distance is no longer an issue is a very compelling tool.